Okay, looks like Obama's stimulus plan may produce 600,000 jobs this summer. The economy was much worse than I expected it to be at this point. And I'm going to talk about Tom Lykus. I hope I don't rock the boat too much.
If I mean more than you're right, I guess you're right.
Hello, it's June 8th, 2009. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcat. First, unemployment. It was worse than I expected it to be. If you want to know the unemployment numbers, I have links in my description box. I would pay a lot of attention to the U6 number because that's the more accurate number. A member of the President's Council of Economic Advisors said this: "The economy clearly has gotten substantially worse from the initial predictions that were made, not just by the White House, but by all of the private sector." Okay, didn't Jerry Salente predict all this? I mean, what about Mark Farber? Or didn't he mention this? Or what about Jim Rogers or Peter Schiff? I think some people sort of saw this coming. But anyway, the unemployment is worse than I thought it would be. I mean, if you look back at my prediction video, unemployment is a lot higher than I thought it would be. I predicted the economy to have a, well, the Dow to do really, really well in the beginning of this year. And I thought it will start to decline in the spring and summer steadily. Then I thought we'd see a major downturn in the fall. I still think we're going to see a major downturn in the fall. Where are you guys getting your information? Who are you listening to? Because I'm listening to Jim Rogers, Mark Farber, Jerry Salente, Peter Schiff. Are there any other people that have a different perspective or have a different way of forecasting what's going to happen? Because I'm really interested in listening to different people about this. Anyway, a top Chinese banker suggested that the U.S., the Federal Reserve, should start basically issuing treasuries in the Chinese currency. Yeah, that's going to happen. U.S. sales of the Prius stall. Apparently, the Prius is a big hit in Japan. But in the U.S., its sales are down 45%. This is a vehicle that's been promoted and praised by environmentalists and celebrities and all these people. But despite the fact that it gets great gas mileage, people in the U.S. apparently aren't interested. But I think a lot of people just can't afford cars in general. So, I mean, I saw that GM ad talking about how they're going to be leaner and greener and whatever. But I mean, you still have the fundamental problem of people not being able to afford to buy cars. So how do you get over that? Toyota and Honda do better because, well, I mean, they're just the companies are just stronger. You know, they're able to go through these rough patches and survive. GM, I don't think so. Anyway, conservatives did really well in Europe. It sounds kind of strange me saying the conservatives did well in Europe. I mean, I never thought there were any conservatives in Europe, but apparently there are. Actually, I knew that wasn't true. France's leader, he's conservative. He's conservative. And yeah, apparently in Germany, France, Italy, Belgium, and some other countries, conservative parties were actually making some gains. So that's pretty interesting. I guess the people are getting sick of all these bailouts and all these stimulus packages. Let's see what happens here. U.S. journalists sentenced to 12 years hard labor in North Korea. Wow. Planning any vacations, anyone? The president will announce plans to tap into the $787 billion stimulus package. Apparently, they're going to create jobs with 10 major projects being implemented over the next 3 months. They're promising to spend thousands, well, they're going to create thousands of new jobs on maintenance projects, on military bases, about 1,600 roads and airport projects. They're going to hire 135,000 teachers and other school staffers, 125,000 summer jobs for youth under supervision of the Labor Department, and I don't understand how this is going to create something that's permanent, something that's substantial. I don't know. I mean, these stimulus packages, they're just not going to work. They don't make any sense to me. I mean, I guess if you were going to create a stimulus package, I mean, I guess you would probably be better off giving grants to entrepreneurs or something like that, something that might actually sustain, or grants for research. Anyway, it's time for my new segment. It's called Rock the Boat. Rock, 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 rock the boat. Rock, 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 rock the boat. Okay, because of my views on marriage and kids, I've been accused of being a Tom Likas listener. Now, for those of you who don't know who Tom Likas is, he is an entertainer. He had a radio show in Southern California. It broadcast all across the country. He had an online podcast. Yes, I did listen to Tom Likas, and I really loved his show, the whole format and the whole idea. He pretty much broke down what guys need to do to basically get laid without spending too much money and too much energy. That was the whole idea behind that whole segment. And I think he's a great entertainer. I mean, besides that, I mean, a lot of things he said was pretty true. There's a lot of things he said that really pissed people off that I thought was just absolutely hilarious. For example, he had this three-date rule. He believed that if a woman didn't have sex with you by the end of the third date, you should probably move on. You should just move on. And, you know, it sounds really harsh, but when you think about it, if a woman doesn't want to have sex with you, then she probably doesn't have much interest in you. There's another rule he had, the $40 a date rule. Don't spend more than $40. You should spend as little as possible. But, I mean, that, of course, makes sense, too, because, you know, if the woman likes you, she likes you. I mean, the amount of money you spend isn't really going to help your chances of getting anything you want anyway. So I think it's a pretty good rule. There's a lot of things he said I disagreed with. He also had this interesting idea that guys should follow their dreams, complete their careers, and then when they're around 40 or something, then settle down with a woman that was about 20 or 25. Actually, he said 25. I thought it was a pretty interesting idea because I thought it would be a lot better for two people to get married when they're at the point in their lives where they're best suited to really take care of a kid. I feel like if a guy simply doesn't get a girlfriend or doesn't get married and really focuses on his career for the first two decades of his adult life, he could actually build up enough wealth to actually support a kid and give that kid the life he really or she really deserves. And if a guy simply play the field and meanwhile focus all his attention on his career, when he's 40 or 45 years old, he can have the money to support a family, and he can marry a 25-year-old, and that would be a much better option for a guy than to get married at 25 to another 25-year-old, because most guys really don't have the money at that point to really support a kid. But I don't know, what do you think about all that? What do you think about Tom Likas? What do you think about his whole philosophy? There's a lot more to it. I hope I didn't rock the boat with this video. Anyway, please leave a comment. Have a good day. Bye.